Hello, YouTubers, and welcome to today's episode of Playbook TV. Today, we will continue our logo match. However, in this episode, we're going to be doing something a little different. We're going to, I plan to break this episode into a series of 2 to 3 videos whereby I show you kind of like an abridged pipeline for creating and applying a visual identity for a fictional brand. So today's prompt for the 30-day logo design challenge organized by the good guys at Logo March. Today's challenge is for the brand name Vada. Now, Vada is fictional, it doesn't exist in Google, I don't know. So it's called Vada. And what is Vada? Vada is an online shopping platform where people can barter or sell personal items, which, you know, it's cool. Now, I'm going to take a very simple approach to this design. I think I just kind of like put it together in my head, and I will just show you how I work. This is not going to be a speed run because I want for you to see my process in real time, and then hopefully you can get like a few ideas and a few tips while I work. So let's begin. Keep this in mind. Let me copy an image if I have to from this. I open Adobe Illustrator. You know, I usually work with A4, it's nice. Set it to the landscape orientation. And then, okay. So here's our blank canvas or artboard. You are of that orientation. So So let's paste what we already have. Zoom out. So like I said, I want to create a very simple, unique identity. Wow, what's this? That's weird. Okay, let's cancel that. Send that out. So let's type in Vada. So let's see. Look for a font that pleases me greatly. And this looks decent. Vada. So Montserrat. Looks nice, not bad. Let's keep it here. Create it. Create our elements. So the key now is to, is what I have in mind, is to use this V to represent everything. I kind of have a feeling that my approach has been used elsewhere. So turn this upside down. So I'm trying to select. And it has a very unique, simple, elitist you. Alright, so let's try something a little different. I had this idea that I was gonna put a circle around here. But I'm not sure. Alright. So let's try to put a small circle. Some sort. Yeah. Probably that one won't, so yeah. Set this guy to the middle. Do this guy. Set it here. So this already looks too much. So I'm gonna use this guy. It's too intense. And whatever inspiration strikes us next. So, what do I do next? Well, I was thinking, this guy, right about here, and then transforming it in this direction. That looks stylish. Let's remove the D. Alright, so we have this. We're left with this. Let's remove the D. Let's not do that again. Alright, so let's try with our circles again. I want the circles to be a guide to help lead the brand to be straight in. So that's not so far. Still feels too much. So I'll just remove them. Leave the circle for this guy. Maybe not. Can't really tell. So perhaps we should consider. I mean, because this looks good, yeah, but translating it into something bold, this is it, I think I have to keep in mind that this isn't a an elitist a premium or super overly premium brand. This is a marketplace, yeah. I have to always remember that this is a marketplace, so like anyone can be a part of it if you want to. Anyone can be a part of it if they want to. Mr. Speed. Not everything is perfectly aligned. It's just about that. So I will take this guy. It's probably shaped right now. And I will try to meld it. No, not really. So let's do that again. Take that. So the idea behind this is so that the D is more Maybe I should stop these two jokes. So that the D is more legible. Okay. But it still feels fat. Well, not fat, but chunky. So let's keep it elsewhere. This is also not a bad idea. So let's keep it here. I was thinking of triangles. Maybe I was. Let's see. If I have a triangle. Let me whip up a triangle from here. See how far it takes me. Triangle. You'll be surprised how I sometimes feel like I can spell triangle. Thank you, autocorrect. Let's set up for a play button since we probably don't have triangle. Oh, this looks promising. This guy here. Yeah. Got his illustrator to treat it as a separate document, but you know, no worries, you can just drag it back and you know, work with it. This is nice. Okay, so let's bring this guy here. This is our D. This is our A. This is our other A. This is our V. I kind of like this one. My problem is, would it be difficult to read? Also, it looks like like a Street Fighter moveset. Down, up, forward, up. So let's try and see if we can get our turning right. For this, I'll probably have to use a circle. There. Surprise, it's actually quite correct, or at least for the most part. If anything I've learned is sometimes obeying turns, sometimes obeying turns doesn't necessarily give you very nice creative results. So you can see that while this looks good, this and this are like on two different planets. So what I can try to do, what I can try to do is, I'll make this half. I'll make this half. And I'll make this other guy half as well. Let's see the results. 2, 3, 4. Oh god, still. Wow. This is gonna be a nightmare. Circle to confirm that I have one or not. Like, why? Oh my god, why am I rotating your circle? Alright. Okay, that is about enough for me. Come here. This. So clearly that's not gonna work. Because if we did this, you'd be shutting up a whole different type of game. Well, this doesn't even add up in any capacity. Except, yeah. Still looks weird. Because it's the same triangle, foot, no better directions. Let me see. Let me copy this. Due to what we were before. I'm thinking perhaps this is a better, you know, than this guy. No. We could try to let's see if I can try to keep the D on the same line. Okay, fine. No more D jokes. I am tired. What the hell? Can we do that? Is it possible? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if we kept everything in the same line, we managed to trim everything to the same line, we would have an irregular triangle or an irregular D. Oh god. I'll probably go to hell for this. So this is definitely not a direction to follow. So we have options. I mean that's nice. We have like a bunch of options now that we can actually pick from. Guys aside, so I just want something that I can quickly build an identity out of at the end of the game. So but so, so what would be the best approach to this? Because I'm trying. Ah, this is gonna be hard. Like trying to pick an identity that works. No, I'm trying to pick a logo that works best for whatever identity vision I have. right now, it's going to be a struggle. So, first of all, this looks good, but it's too complex. So, out you go. This looks irregular. It looks good, but I don't know. This D here is I can't really defend it. So, I think this is a lot better than this guy. Like, the D here is unique, it's very crafty, you know, but I don't think it sells. So we're stuck with these two options. Now, the bigger challenge between this guy and this guy is, this looks premium, high-end, expensive. Well, this looks gamerish, you know, and I think it looks gamerish. I think we can get away with it with some aspects of it. It looks more than gamerish, general front-facing, but general public kind of thing. So we can bet on this. We can bet on this guy. All right, so let's try something. So let's try and talk around. Since the concept of battering, if we're gonna assign meaning, so this definitely, you know, talks about trade. You know, often an offer coming in, a response to that offer going out, like an exchange. This looks like an exchange, you know. This looks like selling. You know, so if someone comes to you with an offer, do you want to oblige the offer, or do you want to like move on and carry on? So this which would be, we are trying to envision a typical marketplace setting. So this is barter and this is sales. So just that there, so I'll miss it. So this is barter and sales. Bad looking. So now that we've decided on the logo that we're gonna run with, I think it's best we choose colors. So I'm gonna create a new artboard. And then I will put my color name, selected logo here. Scale it up a bit so I can see what I'm doing. And I really love this. I love this logo because it's very simple, it's very unique, and like you could build a very solid brand around this, because anywhere you dump it, it's easily memorable. You can easily remember this. You know, it appeals to gamers. Because, you know, it looks like you said it appeals to, you know, every other person, because it's irregular, it doesn't look like something you've seen before, and you're bound to remember this. Also, if you did this probably looks like the beginning of Wakanda, bitches. So let's not do that. All right, so what colors are we looking at? Let's see. Let's start exploring our color options. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I think at this point we have to decide whether or not we're going to go with flat colors, or we're going to go with gradients. You know, what's going to be our primary colors, what's going to be our secondary colors. You know, these are like very, very important choices that we have to make, and this requires some research. And for that, we will be going to. So for that, we will be going to visit a site that I love that has been around for a very long time. Huh. So you could try like a bunch of other colors, you know, color sites, it's color hunts. which is like really ultra cool. Yeah. But where I go to the most would be Color Lovers. So I don't know if they still update the site. I think they do, but they just haven't like they haven't brought it to the future because the site still looks like plenty old and plenty outdated. But it's fine, I believe. Oh wow! Okay, this is a forced. Yeah, some things I talked about. Yeah, so, oh great. Let's try that one more time. So, let's look for e-commerce, yeah. Then, so, you know, going for mostly green. Green is a very. And you won't be able to do much with green. I like this set. This color is looking nice. Oh great, this thing is like frozen again. I'm not doing this for you guys. I'm sorry. I think we'll just go to Color Hunt. Alright, so let's look out for what we could use out of here. I like this. I really like this. Wish I could. Like this. I like this. This is very calm. This view. I like this actually. It has there's a sincerity you could bring to the brand with this guy. Too loud. I don't want to use blue. This. This color has a crazy color set. No, I'm gonna stress. Alright, so let's see. Popular theme. I'm not sure anyone's adding any new stuff there. Oh, apparently you do add new stuff. That's nice. That is very nice. Okay, so let's see. What can we pick from here? Not you. No, I think we're good. Okay, so let's see. I kind of like this color because show me the color I want to see. You come back here. Copy you. Come back here. It does feel like slave work. I know. Yeah, but you know, it's part of your process, and there's pretty much nothing to do. I'm pretty sure if someone made like an Illustrator plugin to pull colors from a site like that. I think that would be really amazing. Alright, so I think we've got our colors nailed down. Do I want to like nail down like a bunch of alternatives? Let's see. Does Vardas come across as a green? Let's try this guy. This guy, I think I'll just try to stick with two colors here. Here. So I'll keep this one just, you know, to have some kind of edge around it. So let's play. Let's have fun.
Yay!
Okay, so I'll create a background now. Let's see. Oh hell no, I'm not doing that. So I'll just do Shift O and duplicate this artboard. One of the key things with working with Illustrator is shortcut keys. Shortcut keys make you move fast, like crazy fast. Like you would not even believe how, like it's insane how fast you'd move if you were very familiar with Illustrator shortcut keys. Okay, so we are now in the spirit of coloring stuff. All right, so what are we giving you? We're giving you this guy. And there's a D. No way, no way, no way, absolutely no way. No way, no. Not even. No way. No. For it to work, it has to be a uniform color. And that color has to be effective wherever we place it. So let me just group it so whenever I tap a color, it just assigns a color to all. Change this guy's background. Nope. Nope. I can do it. Nope. So let's see. What would happen when we did this? Nope. Nope. That's interesting. If you built it as a brand that could look good regardless of colors you put on it. That's gonna require some interesting approach. I want a color that stands out. That color should not be red, but can be. Can be red. Let's take away this gimmick for a bit. Can be red. Not the repulsive kind of red. But that's not gonna work. But nope. This guy. I'm gonna shift O. Pick this color, pick this guy, pick this color. Ugh, God. I don't know. This color isn't just, it's not it. It's not it at all. it does work with this glue. Yeah, but you also have to consider the fact that you need to pick a color that stands out on its own, regardless of the background you're going to place it on, you know. And I think this red, actually works. It's very aggressive, it's very eye-catching. Well, I don't think this qualifies as red. This is not red. God, please. So let me be sure what color this is. So I'll just put it here. Oops, but I'm right. X color. Very light pink red or very light crimson. So let's check out what this color is. I think it's call it very wet, wet watermelon. Okay. So this contains very interesting information. All right. So let's see this guy. What does he have to say? Alright, let's go back here. So we have crimson, you know, very bright pink red thing, which is fine. You know, and we have, you know, our brand, we have Barda there. So let's duplicate this guy and add some shine to it. So one of the reasons why I really like this color, primarily because yeah, it's red, yeah, it's an attraction sign. You can't look anywhere and not see this color. You know, it's not tied to fashion. It's relatable. Well, I think most importantly, because it's an attraction color. Okay, so what do we do? I'm gonna add some chances here. All right, let's see. I'll just duplicate this guy so I can do stuff like this. Gradient to it. Make sure it's white. Make sure that's zero. So that we can stuff like this. Then I think we can also adjust it to fit. So different I want to do it as well. Let's play with it. Let's use orange. And very light yellow. Let's stretch it a bit. A different approach. Let's try this with white. Keep this with brightest yellow so that it feels as a clear, you know, the clear gradual change from the white into the yellow into the pink thingy. So let's move you here. Not that important work. So let's try and Okay, so I'm thinking we should just get like, yeah, that's it right there. And we shall align it to the center, raise it up a bit, and then draw our gradients. Whoa, okay, that was almost, no. Much better. So, that's the appropriate shine that is required. So, we can take you and I turn you this way, which is simpler for me. So that, if I leave it this way, I could just align it here. Doing this guy here, you know, to give it that small tinge edge. Yeah. Can I align this guy here too? Give it some evidence there. Yeah. I like where this is going. The D, and then let's try this guy. We have a right to actually set them in the same direction. Let's put this here. Just should it? Now it might look somehow. So let's just align it then. Everyone has their own uniqueness. So we got the V, the A, D, and the A for dog. Can we improve on this? Probably. I mean, not necessarily the best ideas, but you know, there's always chance that we've got improvement. So, pardon me, I will improve. So, what can I do that will make this game better? Certainly won't do this. Oh, that's sweet. Blur you a bit. That's plenty sweet, actually. It's good looking. Alright, so, let's see. So we have that, and let's move you up also slightly, and here. Yeah, something nice that we can use. The dog. So the color we're using, that's for that. Maybe we could, so let's see if we can stress it as a gradient on its own. This looks good, by the way. That usually is for itself. I want this A to have its own character. I'll think of something. If not, well, I'll let it rest. Alright, so we got this. Let's see if we can apply a single gradient to all of them. Linear, of course. Definitely not you. Have this red. Have you. You might get 100%. You. Or you. So. This looks nice. However, if we do this. Or this. Stick it outside so that it spreads more naturally. So this is too deep a red. Just have to, no? No. Okay, this is cool. So, what about if we went back here and tried a different approach? Make sure that they are aligned, make sure they're not. These guys aren't, so we can just put that there. Set it to base. That doesn't look too awkward. And I don't know, there's this level of unevenness that this thing has. You're definitely not doing that. Alright, so let's do this. This looks like something of an institute. But you'd have very serious problems. If it's fully supposed, you'd have very serious problems when implementing it on the website, because it just doesn't look right, and this would have legibility problems. Alright, so let's move this guy. And we'll maintain this guy for now. Alright, so let's continue our experiment, which looks disgusting. It looks nice, but it still doesn't have that terminal tapping that I need from it. Let me see. Nah, this is my. So I think I'll just settle on this. I'll just settle with this. I'll just settle with this. Although I'm pretty sure that the final identity will not need these gradients, and this is just going to be treated as an exploratory work. I think this is perfect on its own. I think this is perfect on its own. I think that's it. There we go. So, let me just keep this guy the same size. So let's then separate these two. I think keeping them in separate upwards would actually do the trick. Here and this here. Why don't I explore with these colors I've collected to see if there's like something I can work with. Just to see. So got you. This. This is perfect, actually. Yeah. So this is a good fit for my board I have in mind. Yeah. One little dark and grungy. Yeah, let me just save this color set so that I can look for it. Again, this is nice. This is grungy. Cute. This would definitely not work. Or this. Got like a McDonald's feel. or this. Or could it? Let's see. No. So the only way this would work is if this took like a really sharp contrast in color. And this won't work so well on white background. Except we have a plan to implement an all greened out website, or wherever it is that we're gonna appear, the brand is gonna appear, you're gonna have this background, but you can't always anticipate for that. You always have to think about every single scenario. How is it gonna look like on a white background? How is it gonna look like on a black background? How is it gonna look like on a generic any other surface? So whatever color you're gonna pick at the end of the day, it has to shine regardless where it's placed. And it also, so it has to shine regardless of the background, and it has to shine if it's being placed beside other competing brands. So those are the things that you actually have to think about. So this won't work, so let's undo that. So I think we'll just go with our winner here, this color, because I think it has a vibe of it, which I really like. So let's even test it with this guy. Let's test it with this guy. Not bad. Not bad. Let's see if we can tease it with some, oh, I don't know, glow effect. Now, I've been using Illustrator for a very long time. I can tell you that Illustrator's glow, default glow, actually sucks. Now, if you want to get a good, if you want to get a good, glow on Illustrator, I don't know. I'm not really sure you can even, that's even possible. I wish you could do something like that with the mesh tool, but I haven't really dedicated time to actually perfecting my knowledge of the mesh tool. So let me try what I can try, and if I'm lucky, well, good luck to me. Let's preview. Oh, great, it doesn't allow me to zoom. Alright, so increase this guy. So, if you've been using Illustrator a lot, you'll notice that beyond a certain point, it begins to show as boxes. It doesn't have that natural feel of, and this is actually quite nice, actually. I dig this. Let's get in there and take a look at this. Oh, this is lovely. This is lovely. This is some very lovely stuff. Let's fill this up slightly. Put that up a bit. I need to reduce the capacity so slightly. This is perfect, actually. All right, so I think we have a good one here. Smoothie. I think we have a good one here. Have a good one in our hands. We can do this. We can work with this. So I am thinking in our next video, we will be talking about, or we'll be showing how to actually present this logo on more branded surfaces. When I mean by branded surfaces, I mean how would this logo look on a business card? How would this logo look on a letterhead or whatever branded assets or branded materials that you have in mind? How would this logo actually look? What are the things that we need to have in place to make it look great wherever it is that you're going to put it on? And on a third series, the third video series for this, we'll be looking at how to create an actual online portal, an actual online portal with this logo, how it's gonna look, how it's gonna feel. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So this first video, which is this one, this will have a created logo, which I've just shown you. Second video is for, you know, putting logos in mockups and, you know, preparing them to present to the client. And the third video is going to be on how to create an e-commerce mobile app with this guy. That's pretty much. So thank you all for staying along for this ride. I really appreciate. If you like what I've been doing so far, please hit the like button, subscribe, and push that bell so that you can be notified whenever I create new stuff. Also, I have a Patreon account now, so you can support what I do by visiting my Patreon account. It's patreon.com/playbooktv. Patreon.com/playbooktv. And you can take on whatever tier easily works for you. If, just by pledging a dollar every month, you'll be helping me to ensure that I put out really, really great stuff to help beginner designers generally. Alright, so thank you guys very much for watching, and I will see you in the part 2 of this video. Alright, bye bye.